Today, you might be witnessing history in the making. I am so excited to tell you about this, I cannot wait any longer. This new paper is called Alpha Evolve, and it is absolute insanity. I had the honor of having a look at it earlier before its release, and it's been days now, and my head is still spinning. You see, about 900 of our videos ago, or 9 years ago, this was the state of the art in AI. Yes! Now you might think I flipped out because a neural network learned to rotate this car into a frontal position or that it sorted these lines. But no, not at all. I flipped out because it learned not just to solve a task at hand, but because it learned to create an algorithm to do that. I thought this concept might make it big one day. And now, 9 years later, finally, this is the day. Here is Alpha Evolve, an evolutionary coding agent that grows algorithms and computer code out of nothing. It is absolutely crazy. It was given 50 open problems in mathematics, geometry, combinatorics, and more. And in 75% of these cases, it was able to rediscover the best solution the smartest humans were able to come up with so far. That is already insanity, but that's nothing, because in 20% of the cases, it even improved upon previous solutions. Yes, an AI that is able to push humanity forward in a way that no human can. I think this is a historic moment, but get this. There is more! It also discovered a faster matrix multiplication algorithm than one of the landmark techniques, which is called the Strassen algorithm. That is ridiculous! This area is so old, so saturated with so many works, it is almost impossible to come up with something that is just a tiny bit, maybe 1% better. They say that no one was able to do that in 56 years, and after the 56 years, not a human did it, but an AI technique did. Wow! This means that we are in for a crazy AI ride where these methods will start to improve things that we thought are impossible to improve. For instance, don't forget, AI techniques themselves are also running on matrix multiplication. So, what does it mean? Well, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, and check this out. It learned to improve circuit designs for chips meant to run these AI techniques, and it also improved its own training algorithm. Yes, you heard it correctly. It is able to create a better piece of hardware that it runs on, and it also improves its own code. That sounds insane. So, how does it do it? Well, first, you can mark a piece of code that you want to evolve some logic to decide whether a new algorithm is better or worse, and any comments that you might have. And then, off it goes in an evolutionary loop. Then, a new piece of code emerges that gets better and better over time. So, is that new? Nope. No, no, no. Evolutionary algorithms have existed for a while now. For instance, you see my genetic algorithm building up the Mona Lisa from a bunch of triangles. You start out from a random configuration, and it over time evolves into the correct solution. It very loosely mimics how evolution works in nature. The link is in the description. I wrote it by hand, and it shares some very rough basic concepts with Alpha Evolve. But Alpha Evolve is a supercharged, AI-infused variant of that. It is space technology compared to this program. By the way, Alpha Evolve also solved a variant of the kissing problem too. What is that about? Well, this is not about a robot doing whatever the heck it is doing here. Nope, this is one of the crazy names mathematicians like to come up with. And if you think these spheres kissing each other is so weird, well then, look at this. Oh my goodness. This is the hairy ball theorem. It doesn't have anything to do with this new AI, but I couldn't resist mentioning it. Mathematicians and their weird naming schemes. You'll get used to it, don't worry. So, what happens now? Well, I think I have an idea, and it's pretty insane. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. I think they are going to alpha all the things. But I hear you asking, Károly, what do you mean by that? Well, earlier, DeepMind came up with AlphaGo, an AI technique that was able to play Go on a superhuman level. Then AlphaStar, to play the strategy game StarCraft at the very least on a level of a human champion, perhaps even better. But both of these are the wrong way to think about their Alpha project. These are all experiments to create generally intelligent AI techniques that can learn and do so much more than just play Go and StarCraft. And Alpha Evolve is finally one of these. This one learned something so much more general. Computer coding. And it can code up so much more than just chess and Go. You see, computer code underpins almost everything we do. So, yes, it will be able to design better hardware for itself to run on, and it gets better. Perhaps even the next version of Alpha Evolve will be written by Alpha Evolve itself. Get it now? Sir Demis Hassabis, DeepMind CEO, keeps saying that step number one is solving intelligence. And step number two is using this intelligence to solve everything else. He says the following, quoting, "I think one day, maybe we can cure all disease with the help of AI. Maybe within the next decade. I don't see why not." End of quote. Once again, cure all disease, perhaps in the next decade. Sounds crazy, right? But don't forget, this is not coming from some guy. This is coming from a person who just won a Nobel Prize in chemistry with his AI technique. You know what? I could not imagine how this could be true, but with Alpha Evolve, you know, now I am a believer. So, yes, let's alpha all the things, and with the help of human ingenuity plus AI, we might be able to cure all disease in the next decade. What a time to be alive! Here you see me running the full DeepSeek AI model through Lambda GPU Cloud, 671 billion parameters, running super fast and super reliably. This is insane. I love it. And I use it on a regular basis. Lambda provides you with powerful NVIDIA GPUs to run your own chatbots and experiments. Seriously, try it out now at lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the description.